Hey, thanks for joining me in another lesson in working with Microvellum Toolbox. Now, before we get going on drawing this new kitchen, I wanted to mention a couple things. If you're just getting started with Microvellum, I suggest taking some time and checking out our basic training plan videos to help get more familiar with the interface. But if you don't want to follow along step by step during this video and just want to see how a new kitchen can be drawn relatively quickly using Toolbox, then sit back and enjoy the show. All right, now it's time to start laying out some cabinets. And here we are in this new kitchen project, taking a look at the design that we're going to create in this video. The idea here is that we can go through the steps to show how we can effectively draw a new kitchen layout using all the products and hardware that are standard inside of the foundation library. We have a few upper cabinets using the Blum Eventos lift-up hardware, along with some other base cabinet inserts that can easily be added with just a few clicks on your mouse. We also have the appliances included, and I'll show you how we can turn on another cool Blum product inside of your cabinets. This one is called the Space Step. Now, before we start adding these products from our library into this drawing, we need to set up the project properties, and that means the cabinet size defaults and the hardware that we're going to be using throughout this project. So the first step is to go into the Microvellum palette and then into project properties, into the project wizard, and into cabinet size defaults. I've already set up the tall cabinet height along with some of the other defaults, so be sure to match these on your end. Now into the global variables, I wanted to also turn off a couple things to speed up this drawing process. The first thing will be to turn off the display product description, so as we bring in the products from the library, we won't see that text appear, and also the dimension for each product that's coming from those 2D plan drawing tokens. Most of the other settings that we have, we're just going to leave as default, but we are going to change our hardware. So into the material wizards and then load the hardware wizard. First, for the cabinet door hinges, we'll make sure that the hinge brand and hinge plate brand are set to Blum. We'll be using the Blum full overlay hinges on our standard cabinet doors. And we also have a couple of corner cabinets, so we want to make sure that we're using the correct 45-degree angled hinge on those. And for that, you're going to want to select the one that just says the Blum overlay inserta. For the drawers on this project, we are going to use some undermount slides, so we'll be selecting this Blum tandem. We also have the option to change the default drawer boxes. For right now, we're just going to keep it as a dovetail drawer box, but there's other drawer systems in here as well that you can select from. And under this additional hardware tab, you can select the different type of door stay. So because we have those lift-up cabinet doors, we're going to want to make sure that we have the correct Eventos hardware turned on. You can also do it inside of each product, but here we'll be throughout the entire project. And like always, just make sure to save and close to keep those changes. So along with some of the things that we've already done inside of the global variables to speed up this process, we also want to go into our toolbox options and make a couple changes there too. The first one being under the AutoCAD tab and under drawing preferences, have the 3D drawings with minimal machining and shelf holes turned on. Also make sure that we have the add 2D plan tokens to 3D turned on as well. Okay, and now it's time to start putting together this drawing. So we'll go to the draw tab and then draw room components and then using the pick points option to place these walls. Selecting our first point, and we're just going to drag it over 142 inches, then the next wall at 156, and then the final wall, making it also 142 inches. Just to make it look a little bit nicer, for this drawing, we are going to add a floor. So just to draw a simple rectangle first, by typing in REC in the command line, we're able to use our toolbox command to create floor from polyline. And also just for a more visually appealing kitchen, let's add a bay window to this wall. Now I have my custom tool strip set up already. If you don't have yours set up, I suggest you take the time to do that. Into the product prompts, and now into that wall room component. And then over to our window options, we can select which window we want and where we want it to be located on this wall. So we're going to make sure that it's centered and hit OK. There we go. That looks nice. Now we can start laying out some cabinets. Now, typically in a kitchen, there's always going to be a few things that are going to be constant. One being a sink, and maybe another one being a range or an oven. So we're going to start off with our sink. And knowing that I want it to be centered underneath this window, that's where we're going to start. And now, selecting the midpoint on this wall, it doesn't matter if it's at the floor or at the top. These toolbox products are smart enough to know whether it's a base or an upper, so it gets located correctly. So as long as you're selecting that midpoint, that sink cabinet will draw right below this window. And if we want to go back and make any changes to this cabinet, for instance, this faucet, we can do that. Now, this faucet is actually inside of the countertop, which is a subassembly of the sink cabinet. So we'll need to go to subassembly prompts. Here I have it in my tool strip as well. Change that faucet type, and hit OK. Now, if it's not in your custom tool strip, you can find it under the Modify tab and Modified Subassemblies. Now, the other thing that's going to be a fixed position in this kitchen is going to be our range and our range hood. So those will be the next two products that we place on this adjacent wall. First, with the range hood, again, find that midpoint on the wall. We'll select that range hood with the curved glass. And then the freestanding range. This one, we're just going to change the brand and make it a 5-burner range. So now that we have these products placed on our walls, we need to start filling up the rest of the space with some more cabinets. Now, typically a good way to work would be starting in the corners and then working your way out from there. So that's what we're going to do. Since we already had our products that needed to stay in those fixed locations, we can bring in the corner cabinets and then fill in the rest of the space from there. Let's give this a new width and a new depth of 36 inches. You can hit tab to quickly go from cell to cell. Then next into the internal options, and we're going to change the component options to a pullout and the face options to a right swing. Now you'll notice that countertop came in with no splash on the back, so we'll have to go back into the product and turn that on. The backsplash is turned on throughout the project in the global variables, but because this corner cabinet has some special conditions, it's going to be a left side backsplash and a right side backsplash. You'll have to go into this product and make that change at the local level. Now we should have 24 inches left over for our dishwasher, which is going to go right next to that sink. We'll do the same thing to the other corner, mirroring that cabinet, matching the width and the depth. Again, the pullout, and this time we're just going to leave the face options as a left swing. Oh, I forgot to do the countertop again, so back into countertop options, left edge detail and right edge detail to a backsplash. And to the left side of that sink cabinet, we're going to have a trash pullout. And this product is already set up with the hardware included, so we're going to place it next to another product. Double click in the cell, and we can pick two points in this drawing, 24 inches, so that works out perfectly, and then selecting the waste bin type. I'm just going to change my view here because one thing with that waste bin, because it's a drawer, the handle is automatically centered. So we're going to go back into the subassembly prompts on that one, and I'm going to change the handle location. And instead of it being centered on the drawer, I'm just going to hard code it and give it 3 inches down from the top. Now let's stay on this wall here and finish up the base cabinets. We're going to add the dishwasher next to the sink cabinet, which will be found under the appliance category. And this one's real simple. Just place it next to the other product. I'm just going to change the brand of the appliance, but it fits right there inside of our 24-inch opening. So we're ready to move on to the next wall. Now, I typically like to lay out all my base cabinets first with the appliances, and then from there, go back and start adding in some upper cabinets. So we have two cabinets that we'll need to add to each side of this range, and then we'll add our tall pantry cabinet at the end. Now, sometimes I find it a little bit easier to add products from a top view, so you can make that change going into your views and selecting top. Also, UPL in the command line for the shortcut. And we're going to use two of our base one door, one drawer products. So we have just a little bit over 17 inches, but we do need to give it a little bit of space next to our range. So we'll change that to 16.5, turn on the right finished end. And now that'll automatically turn on a countertop overhang, which we'll want to also adjust. So the 16.5 is going to be our cabinet size, and then a countertop, which is 1/4 inch greater than that. Now let's mirror that cabinet on the other side of this range, doing the same thing. We know it's going to be the same size as the other, this time just a left finished end with the right swing. And we'll change our right reveal in here also, since we know it's going to be butted up next to a tall pantry cabinet. Now you'll notice here that the cabinet was placed directly next to that range, but the countertop is extending into it. And that's because the products use the base point of the cabinet for reference. So back into the Microvellum palette, and we can simply just move this cabinet over 1/2 inch. Now that'll also give us 1/4 inch gap in between the cabinet and the range. Now reminder, use the Microvellum move here and not an AutoCAD move to move this cabinet. Now let's find that tall pantry cabinet and again, place it next to another. Double click in here, find out how much space we have left that we're working with. We'll take off a couple inches to make sure it lands short of that wall. Now into the toe kick height, we also want to make this adjustment to 6 inches. And I'll show you why in just a second after we turn on a couple finished ends. Now into construction options, into the toe kick assembly, and we're going to use the toe kick drawer Blum space step. And that's why we changed it to a toe kick height of 6 inches, because the space step won't work with anything less than 6 inches. And you can change what's inside of this cabinet by going into the internal options. We'll give it some inner drawers, change the adjustable shelf quantity. And now right click in this open space and we can open up the subassembly for those inner drawers. And this will give us access to the drawer quantity of that subassembly. Also, any space from the top or in between drawers that you want, we're just going to give it 3 inches from the top and 3 inches between. Now let that new tall cabinet draw in, and we'll have it with our adjustable shelves, inner drawers, along with that space step. Before we change our view to see what that looks like, let's continue adding this upper cabinet right next to it since it's going to match the base below. We'll align it with the countertop. Give it a right swing and also a right door reveal of 1/8 of an inch. I can change our view. Just orbit that around and you can see there we have our space step included along with some inner drawers and our shape adjustable shelves. Adjustable shelves are also a subassembly, so if you don't like that curved front edge, just go into the subassembly prompts and make that change. So let's continue adding more upper cabinets. Again, starting in the corners and working our way out, the corner products we'll use this time will be the diagonal corner cabinets. These will be 24 inches wide with just a single door. And instead of them just having flat slab doors, let's turn them into glass doors. Now this can be done by going into the finished faces subassembly, but first I want to make sure the interior is using finished material. For that, the product type must have open in the name. So let's change it to upper open. Then right click to show subassemblies, then the prompts of the finished faces, and turn on glass door. Okay, now it's time for some rinse and repeat. Let's add a couple more uppers on either side of that corner cabinet. I'm just going to change my view to a top view again. First, a two-door upper, picking 2 points to align with the countertop below. And now on to the sink wall. This product actually already includes the glass door by default, so no need to dig into the subassemblies on this one. Just give it the correct width and update a few of the prompts. Now I'm going to jump ahead a little bit since these next two cabinets are the same as the previous, just mirrored. Then on to finishing up this kitchen. When placing the fridge cabinet, we want it to match the distance away from the wall we had with the pantry. While hovering over this corner, I'm going to move my cursor in the direction of where the base point will be and give it a value of 2 inches. Then press enter, and now we can change some of the things we want with this cabinet. First, the opening height. Let's give it 70, so the upper doors on this cabinet will match the height of the next set of uppers. And maybe give it a different type of component insert. So this cabinet already has the fridge appliance included, which is also a subassembly with its own unique prompts and ways to make it draw however you like. And finally, for the last set of base and uppers. For these cabinets, we're going to fill a specific space with the quantity we need. Select pick points, then the space in between. Now to change the height of the drawers, right click, and this time we have a calculator option. Select that and enter a new height for the drawers. The ones with the checkbox will be calculated to fit. Then again, we'll add the uppers the same way. You could use a standard upper and change the finished face type to a lift-up door, but since we already have those products in our library, that's what we'll use to fill up the space. And now picking the first point where the products are going to start, and then the second point where the products will end. And changing the height, and then giving it only one adjustable shelf. The stay system is coming from the properties of the project in the hardware wizard, but we could change that here if we wanted to. Okay, everything is looking good. Now maybe a miter fold shelf to finish it off. They seem to be pretty popular. Now I'm going to go back to using the option to place the product next to another one. And then as always, update the width of the product. Also double check the height above floor. And then we can add some lights to this product too. Now under the light options tab, we can change the downlight quantity. And also, if we want to, the downlight type. But for now, we'll just leave them as they are, hit OK, and add this miter fold shelf to our kitchen. Now this is a pretty cool product. Not only does it have the option to cut out for the lights at the machine, but it'll also produce a good rendering since the lights have been added to the product as a piece of hardware with drawing blocks. Now we're not going to get into the rendering process now, but after playing with the materials and more lighting, this kitchen can be ready for presentation. But to make sure that it matches the rest of the cabinetry, the name of the product type has to include open. So back into the prompts, under advanced options, and changing the product type. And there it is, a complete kitchen in Microvellum Toolbox using the standard default products in our foundation library. Okay, well that'll do it for this one. Thanks again for joining me in another session and working with Microvellum. I'm RJ, and I'll see you next time.